is a hard game, don't you blame. It's your chance to rise your aim. Let your spirit be brave, always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
Interesting. Impressive.
Thank you. I've traveled the world just to collect all those things. I spent a lot buying all that.
Well spent.
Thank you. Bruce, do you want to know something else? I'm thinking about writing a book about martial arts. The other day at your house, you said a lot that could help me.
I'm glad. You know, as long as you need my help, I'd be glad to talk. Also, that would help my Quan Shu develop more.
Bruce, the other day I came across this book on Taoism and then I bought it. A lot of it can be applied to fighting. At least I think so. What are your thoughts about it?
You want to hear it? Basically, Taoism is about dealing with things without imposing. You must be dialectic. Dialectic about your thinking. For example, the material and immaterial can trade places anytime. An offense can also be a defense, working at the same time. Actually, with Taoism, I'm not that familiar. Taoism is deep and very profound, like Kung Fu. With regards to dealing with things without imposing, it's control based on natural order. However, it does not mean you're not in control. Also, it's immaterial. There are no fixed movements to follow. You're allowed to use different styles. The true way of fighting.
Wait a minute. Let me write it. Please, go on.
The concept of Taoism has many theories. One must possess a peaceful mind, shutting out necessary thought. We're taught this during childhood. Why is it people who practice Taoism are always up in the mountains? Know why? It's simple. Because they don't want to be distracted. When practicing Kung Fu, our mind must be calm as water. And when we fight, we shouldn't think unnecessarily of winning or losing. It causes our bodies to stiffen. Because only when our minds are at peace, it is only then can we strike with precision. That is when the material becomes immaterial. We can therefore control and not impose. Professor, I am but a novice. You're the expert.
Of course not. What you said is very helpful.
Professor, I would like to borrow this book on fencing.
Go ahead. You want to learn fencing?
I think it's applicable to the techniques I'm developing for Quan Shu.
Bruce, I think it's good if we went outside for a walk. Why talk about just philosophy when we have some guests here?
It's all right, Master. It's actually interesting. I can't fully grasp what you and Bruce are talking about. It would be easier to understand if you went out to show it to us.
Exactly what I
I'm glad you agree.
Well, sure, I'd love to. I'd also like to see Filipino-style boxing.
And I'd like to see your Chinese kung fu.
All right, come on.
Pretty good. That should help Bruce's technique, don't you think?
There you go. Now you try it, Bruce. Elbow up. This. There we go.
This.
Right. Smoothly now, Bruce.
Like this?
That's correct. Now, snap it back.
Are you sure?
Come on, do it.
Like this?
Yes, that's right.
That?
Terrific. Now try this. Use your elbow and do it like an uppercut. Yes, you can also use it to block an enemy's attack.
Professor Eno, I think Filipino boxing is very flexible. It's also very fast, except it's not that powerful.
Kimura, what Bruce said makes sense.
Take Young Jun Suan. The attacks are fast and direct. That's its most important point. But its weak point is in the footwork. It's only practical the opponent is within striking distance. If the opponent is this far, then it's okay. Anything farther and this technique is useless. Unfortunately, it has limited reach. Do you understand?
Wait, my stance is like this, this far, then you're saying I'm in range?
Okay, let's try it. Punching with the left fist, even if at half or long range, as a follow-up, the right fist will follow instantaneously. I think it would be better if you kept a safe distance.
It makes sense.
You think so?
Yeah.
What I would like to devise is a simplified Yung Chun Chuan to make the move simpler and less complicated, and combine the centerline theory, combined with the power of Western boxing.
How could that be possible? Yung Chun Chuan and Western boxing can't be mixed together.
Come. Let's try it. And then come at me. Now, one more time. Try to hit me, okay?
Wow, that was fast.
Now, this time, I used basic and direct attacks of Yung Chun Chuan. I attacked it by right, but I combined it with the footwork of Western boxing. And all throughout our fight, I was mindful of our center line. That's very important. Okay, try again.
Okay.
See?
This way I can defend. Even while attacking.
Yes, that's important. You attack and defend at the same time. So while I attack, I still maintain a defensive posture.
Wow. Bruce, that was really great. I didn't think combining fencing with Quan Shu was possible.
Professor, after I got to read that book you lent me, I learned something. The art of fencing can be combined with martial arts. Just like the lunging. I used it just now. In Yung Chun Chuan, you keep your strong fist in front. In fencing, it's almost actually the same. They're similar in using powerful attacks, effective at long range. Before, when I punch with the right fist, I can't move. Because of this, I have limited range. But then, I combine it with the lunge in fencing. And now, I have the range. You see, if you do that, you can still reach them.
Oh, I see. Would you mind demonstrating the one-inch punch to me?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
This way.
Smashing a piece of paper from less than an inch away. Simply amazing.
Professor, actually, it's a variety of steps. We draw power from the ground, from the leg, waist, shoulder, all three combined. Now, when you punch, you have to put your body into it. From the ground, power passes through the legs, waist, back, shoulder to the fist, and it all comes out in one blow. I call this the one-inch punch. Your fist is like the end of a whip. You focus all of your strength to the end of your fist with explosive power. You can even punch through leather.
I see. The fist.
Professor, why don't you try it?
Go ahead.
I'm going to keep this.
Sure. First, you have to remember to relax. Your wrist must not be tight.
All right.
Focus all your power first. Now let it out.
Okay.
your fist now. Relax your muscles. Remember to kick correctly. When you turn, remember center of gravity. Okay, that's enough for today. I guess I'll teach you more tomorrow. Okay?
Okay.
Go ahead and rest.
Yeah. Oh, Bruce. Is it okay if I borrow your notes?
Sure.
Kung Fu is a special skill. It is a subtle art, not just simple physical exercise. It is an art, a blend of many techniques and wisdom, all working in perfect harmony. The principle of Kung Fu is to scientifically exercise your body and mind. The highest level of Kung Fu is the Tai Chi Yin Yang. Tai Chi Yin Yang signifies the essence of everything in the universe. When discussing Kung Fu theory, Tai Chi Yin Yang simplifies all that is complex into two basic terminologies, defense and offense. Traditional fighting is like fighting for the wrong reasons. Even if you gain momentary victory, in the end, you could still lose. So in order to break the psychological barriers, you must be as ferocious as a beast, clever as a fox, quick as a cat, and also precise like a cobra. Once you do all of this, you have achieved mastery of yourself.
Kung Fu is making an impact on people. As for the moment, I have to stay in college. So, I'd like my Kung Fu school to make an impact on our society. And it's important to exchange martial arts knowledge with other people.
But how? Barge into other schools? I think that's not a good idea. If you challenge other schools, you'll use up all your strength. And it's brash.
It doesn't matter to me.
But how will you find the time?
You know, come. It's not a good idea to barge into other schools. So I think it's better if they came to us instead of us going there to challenge them.
I can't believe what you're saying. You're going to challenge masters in our school? And what if you lose in front of our students? We would lose face.
My goal, Kimura, is to devise a new Quan Shu, where winning or losing isn't the key. Understand? Write this down. Listen. No matter the time and place, or person, if I'm challenged, I will be there. Write it down exactly like that. Bruce Lee. Kimura, write it in big letters. I want it on a sign at the entrance of the school.
But Bruce, if we do this, we're gonna look too arrogant.
Just do it. Only this way can you get their attention. It's the best way to develop our Quan Shu. We'll be testing it on other masters. So write it.
You'll be making enemies.
Just do it. Do what I told you.
Challenge me. That's what matters.
That's a little too much.
I still think it's a bad idea.
Come on, stop worrying, will you?
I hear you right. You saw it yourself?
How can I not see it? He put a big sign at the gate of his school. Bruce Lee fights anyone, anytime, anywhere.
Kid is just way too arrogant.
Come. Get up.
Okay.
Kick me.
Master!
Get up.
Can you help me up?
Professor. Masters. Jessie, train on your own.
Excuse me.
Let's go.
We need to talk.
Sure. Please. Professor Eno, what's the problem?
Bruce, what is the matter with you? I saw a sign at the entrance of your kung fu house. It says you'll take on challengers anytime, any place. That's really asking for trouble.
What's wrong with that?
You can't. There are so many martial artists in the States. Your kung fu house will be under constant attack.
I'm not afraid. You want to know something? When I was a kid, I wanted others to teach me. So I just barged into other dojos. So now, in this way, I can get other masters to come and challenge me and in the process learn from them. Isn't that good? Professor Eno, for now, I have to admit my martial arts is still underdeveloped. But I will not lose a fight that easily. Also, my purpose is not to see who is the better fighter, but rather to develop my own style of Quan Shu. I think it's worth the effort, even if I fail. I owe you an apology. We should have talked it over before I put it up.
Bruce, I don't need you to apologize. I'm just worried because of what you did. Many masters will come after you.
Let them challenge me. That's what I want.
Bruce, you have to be prepared for this.
So I will.
It will be good if you do win. But what if you don't? Then you'll lose face in the martial arts community. Your kung fu house will be shut down. Your dream of devising your own kung fu will be no more than a pipe dream.
Master, you got a phone call.
Who is it?
Willie J's dojo.
You see? There's one now. Don't worry, okay?
That sign at your gate. What did you put it up for? Are you challenging every martial artist in North America?
No, that's not it. I just want a way to improve my skills, to test my new theory. By trying it on other masters.
You should have given this more thought. With that sign, what are people supposed to think? If nobody accepts your challenge, then everybody's afraid of you. But what if somebody does accept your challenge? Well, then what? What good is it? Tell me, what would you get out of it? What about the other people? How would this affect all of them?
I don't care about that.
I'm sorry, but I just don't like your attitude, Bruce.
I'm sorry, Master. I didn't realize what I did would offend you. Please trust me, I just want to develop my skills and perfect my Jeet Kune Do. And if possible, Master, I'd like to learn some jiu-jitsu.
No. I can't teach you anymore. If people find out I'm teaching you, then they'll be offended.
If they have a problem, I'll be waiting at the Kung Fu house. If it's offending the martial arts community, well, then that's what it is. I just want to prove myself.
You know, you are my friend. So I have to warn you, Bruce, what you're doing is dangerous. I don't know anyone who's as brazen as you are.
Yes. I want people to know me. If this is how I need to do it, then so be it. The world will know the name Bruce Lee.
It was true. Bruce Lee has issued a challenge to all martial artists. So Bruce Lee is actually challenging all the martial artists in the United States.
James and I saw the sign. It is at the gate of his kung fu house for all people to see. It says anyone, anytime, any place, he will take on all challengers. He's got a lot of nerve.
That kid is too cocky.
That's right, he's just too proud.
But you know, I think Bruce Lee really is a true master.
Preposterous. A few punches from me and he could barely stand. That's the truth. He's probably forgotten what he looked like after I fought with him. That Bruce Lee doesn't have the backbone to challenge me, so he's resorting to tactics like this. I will tear his kung fu house down.
Oh, Master Yamamoto. Must you do that?
As I have said, the state of Seattle is no place for that man.
I just got a call from James. He wants to arrange a match.
That's good. Against who?
This isn't good. He made me put the sign up. I didn't approve. So now, James is coming after you.
Why should I be afraid? I heard he's just a researcher, not a good one. From what I know, he's not even as good as Inosanto. Professor Ino could wipe the floor with him.
Bruce, don't underestimate that man. He used to teach boxing at an athletic college, and then he changed careers. And now, he's a famous promoter in the martial arts world. He put up a center promoting martial arts. He makes a lot of money by promoting matches.
So what does he want?
He saw a money-making opportunity because of that sign. He's trying to get other masters to challenge you.
Exactly what I want.
Master Yamamoto, I don't think it's necessary to humiliate Bruce in his kung fu house. Yes, he did put up a sign that laughed at the face of the martial arts world, but his intention was only to further his knowledge for his Quan Shu.
That's no excuse. What he did disrespected the martial arts code.
I tried to talk him out of it, but he wouldn't take the sign down. I have to admit, what he's doing is quite insulting. But if you try to take it down this way, then you'll be bringing him shame.
Once we are there, Bruce Lee himself will take that sign down.
Yes. It's about time that we taught that Chinese a lesson.
I don't
think
so.
He's too proud. I still don't think you should go there. Firstly, I think this is unnecessary. And second, he's not an ordinary fighter.
I don't think he's all that good. Especially since I've fought him before and he couldn't handle it. He could barely stand.
I'm telling you, he's good. A few months ago, we fought and it was a draw. You better think it over first.
If you ask me, we should teach this Bruce Lee kid a really good lesson. I could organize a match. So many people could see it. Then everyone will see how Bruce Lee will be beaten by Master Yamamoto.
Since he's so cocky, it should be Master Yamamoto who puts him in his place.
Don't worry, Mr. Yamada. He will be humiliated.
What is the center line? Let me explain it to you. Kimura, give me a hand. The center line is our body. Punch, kick. The center line is here. Okay, Kimura, give me a punch. See that? He and I are always in the center line. One more. During defense, it's the same thing. You can go back. The purpose of fighting is to defeat the adversary. If you just defend, he's not going to fall by himself. In my theory of martial arts, you can defend yourself while attacking your opponent. And this way, you can change from defense into an offense. Understood?
Yes, Master!
Blair, step forward. Everyone, watch how Blair and I exercise defense and offense. Blair, attack me. While he's attacking, I'm defending. But I'm also attacking as I defend, like this, you see? Good. Again. Very good. Everybody understand? Even when I'm defending, I can still attack. This is called defensive attack. Good. Moving on. I will teach how to train with a wooden man.
Excuse me, Master. Every time you practice that, we're just so impressed. Today, I was thinking maybe you could show it to us. Right, guys?
Is having a match with you. Shouldn't you be preparing for that?
I'm ready for him. Yamamoto's kung fu is not as good as Roller's.
He's still a first-class fighter.
I'm ready. I've been waiting for this. The last time, he defeated me. But I'm different now. I've also been studying his fighting style.
I may be able to help. We should sit down and talk about this. We can come up with a good strategy.
You're too kind.
It's all right. Bruce, there will be many people that will challenge you. I think you better not expose your skills too much.
What? Why not?
The less they know, the less chance they have of defeating you.
Today I'll teach you the Riji punch. When you throw this punch, there must be no expression on your face. Your body must not look like it prepared for it. All of your energy must explode in one blow. Huh? You got it?
Yes, sir!
Good.
When life is a hard game, don't you blame. It's your chance to arise your way. Let your spirit be brave. Always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
Here goes.
What boxing is that?
Well, you see, before you threw the punch, I was deflecting your attack, but at the same time, I was already attacking too. See, it's simultaneous. While you're defending, you're also attacking. What do you think?
Wait, Bruce. You and Yamamoto are both fast punchers. What makes you so sure that you'll beat him?
Fight speed with speed. Repeat it!
Yes, master! It's hard to defend an attack coming from above and below!
What do you want? Why are you here?
Master Yamamoto, so you have come to teach me.
I've come to see what's so good about your Quan Chu.
I have always wanted to learn from you. Thank you for coming to my Kung Fu house. I am honored.
Then let's get at it.
Wait. One second. I have a request.
What is it?
After we trade knowledge, could you teach me karate?
Trade knowledge? You never stood a chance against me. I just came here to teach you a lesson. And if you must know, here in the States, there's no place for you. You're far too arrogant.
If I belong here or not, we'll know after this fight. Today, we'll see if I am just being arrogant. Before all of your students, before my students, before you, Honorable Master Yamamoto, and you, Mr. Yamada.
Come on.
If you lose today, you'll agree to be my coach. And in return, I will teach you Yong Chun Swan and other things.
You can teach me if you beat me. I'll do anything you want. Come on.
Very good. Come on!
Oh!
Master. I hope, Master, that you will live up to our agreement. One of these days, I will drop by your school. Jessie, put the sign back up.
Okay.
Professor, thank you so much. Everything you said worked. I won.
Hey, was he a fast puncher?
Really fast. His punches were powerful.
I see. So, what did you learn from the fight?
I learned a lot about him. I found out he has trained well in fundamentals. He has the endurance to sustain his attack. His power in punching is so tremendous. A regular person, pow, with just one punch. Would have been knocked out.
Or even knocked out.
Yeah, I would have been knocked out too. So I used what I noticed from him. I made sure he didn't get a chance to hit me. I avoided getting hit. Waited for a chance. I aimed for his vital part. I used a 1-inch punch. And then he fell.
That was fantastic.
Thank you.
Mr. Ed Parker. I'm sorry. But you'll have to excuse me now.
Master Yamamoto, your skills are exceptional. So why did you lose in such a short time? What happened?
I noticed from Bruce Lee's fighting style, it's somewhat influenced by Filipino martial arts. But I doubt he'd have learned that from Danny Inosanto.
Inosanto?
Yes. I once fought with Inosanto. I still remember his fighting style. Inosanto uses many fighting styles, and he also fights with incredible speed.
Except, I thought, Inosanto has never defeated you.
That's why I'm wondering. In karate, we are required to separate defense from offensive attacks. But Bruce Lee's fighting style, it was different. He combined it. You couldn't anticipate his movement, offense or defense, and his fighting style. I couldn't tell what kind of fighting style he was using. It was kind of Filipino, but it was more than Filipino martial arts. Anyway, with Bruce Lee's fighting style, it's like my strength had no effect. His various styles and fast offenses and defenses kept me confused throughout the fight, especially that final punch. So fast, so strong. Bruce Lee's fighting style is well on its way to achieving perfection. His punching power is much stronger than before. Now, I just can't keep up with him.
Master. Master Yamamoto. Bruce Lee called to say he's coming over tomorrow. He wants to spar with you. He says he wants to learn. Master, I doubt his sincerity.
From what I know, Chinese martial artists never expose their martial arts secrets to other schools.
However, I want to learn how he does that powerful punch. Mr. Parker, Lee wants me to teach him karate. How should I teach him?
Professor Ino, tomorrow I'm going to Yamamoto School. I want to exchange martial arts knowledge with him. What technique should I ask him to explain to me, for me to learn?
Bruce, don't expect him to teach you anything. It doesn't matter how bad you want to learn his technique. The martial arts community sees you as a threat. They won't allow you to be better than him.
But still, I have faith in that man. I will teach him all I know. You know what? The reason martial arts is developing so slow? Because nobody shares what they know. Only by exchanging knowledge will martial arts be thoroughly developed. I'm just going to get it started. If he and I share everything we know, it will greatly develop my martial arts. And soon, my martial arts will be perfect.
Then I hope he sincerely accepts what you're offering.
I think he will.
Please, Mr. Lee. I would like to know, what kind of fighting style did you use to defeat me?
Easy. I just put my eye inside your mind.
I don't understand.
You have hit me before. I decided to study what makes your punch powerful and offensive. So, every time you throw a punch, I have to know your intention. So, I put one of my eyes there inside your mind.
I didn't have you come over just to confuse me with your words. You want me in good faith to teach you? Then you must tell me, what style did you use to defeat me?
Okay. Master, watch this. This is what I used. This is the Riji punch.
The Riji punch?
Yes, when I'm defending. I can attack at the same time. When I punch, I focus on your center line. It's usually very effective. The Riji punch requires you to gather all your strength. Focus it all on one point. The essence of this punch is its power and speed. It's very hard to see it coming. The timing has to be precise. So, when the opponent is moving in for an attack, it will unload tremendous force.